Now we will go to discuss the experiment number 6, that is the based on the colligative property. Aim of this experiment is to determine the molecular weight of the given compound by the RAST method. Already we have discussed that RAST method in the theory part in the unit number 2, colligative properties. Okay, what is the theory behind this particular experiment? You know, the melting point of the pure substance is the characteristics property. If another solid is mixed with the pure substance, the melting point of the pure substance will be decreased. This lowering of the melting point is known as the depression of the freezing point. It depends on the molecular weight of the substance and some other factor. The depression of the freezing point is one of the colligative property and is represented by the following equation. That equation also we have derived. Delta TAB is equal to RT0 by 1000 into LF, which is nothing but the 1000 into 1000 into WT upon into W1 is equal to KF into 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1, where K is a molal depression constant or molal kyroscopic constant of the solvent and is defined as the depression of the freezing point, which would be produced by dissolving 1 gram solute in 100 gram of the solvent. This definition also we have seen. Delta TAP is nothing but the depression of the freezing point. Then particularly this T0 is the melting point of this particular pure substance. Then LF is latent heat of the fusion. Then WT is the weight of the pure substance, or say you can call it the molecular weight, which to be determined. Then the W1 is nothing but the weight of the pure substance whose melting is T0, and M2 is the molecular weight of the substance to be determined. It may be noted from the equation number 1 that higher the value of the KF, the larger will be the delta TF. With larger delta TF values, one can find out the molecular weight of the substance under the consideration more accurately. For the substance of the higher molecular weight, it is necessary to use the solvent whose KF values are large. The molar depression constant KF of the naphthalene is quite high, that is a 40, and therefore it is commonly used as a solvent in the molecular determination. However, naphthalene, camphor and the phenol can also be used for the RAST method. The molecular weight of the substance like the acetylide, anthracene, naphthol, etc. may be determined by the RAST method. Here the requirement for this experiment is, we required the hard glass test tubes, boiling tubes, stirrer, thermometer, stopwatch, naphthalene powder, biphenyl, 250 cm3 of the beaker, paraffin oil, etc. We will take the 5 gram finely powdered naphthalene in a test tube. Place the boiling tube in a 250 cm over the beaker containing the paraffin oil bath. Insert the thermometer in a test tube. Heat the paraffin oil bath containing the solid till it reaches 5 degree centigrade above melting point. We have to heat that compound up to the more the 5 degree centigrade. Remove the boiling tube from the paraffin oil bath and keep it in the 250 cm3 of the dry beaker. Allow the melt to cool and note the temperature at the time interval of every 30 seconds. Record the constant temperature. Plot the graph of temperature against time. It is known as the cooling point curve. Estimate the melting point from this cooling curve. This is for the pure naphthalene we are going to do. Then in the set 2, in another boiling tube, take the powder mixture of the 0.1 gram biphenyl and the 5 gram of the naphthalene. We will add that biphenyl 0.1 gram. We will place that test tube in the beaker containing the paraffin oil. Insert the thermometer in the test tube. Heat the paraffin oil bath containing the solid mixture till it reaches 5 degree centigrade above its melting point. Remove the boiling point tube from the paraffin oil bath. Keep it in the 250 cm3 of the dry beaker. Allow the melt to cool and note down the temperature at an interval of the 30 seconds. Record the constant temperature. Plot a graph of temperature against the time. It is known as the cooling point curve, and estimate the melting point from the cooling curve. Very simple it is again. In the observation, what we have to observe? That is a time for the zero. See, we should know 80 degree centigrade is the melting point of pure naphthalene. That's why we have heated 5 degree more. That is a 85. Then we will measure that after the 30 second, we will record the temperature. Here the time is given in the minutes. 30 seconds means the 0.5 minutes, 60 seconds is nothing but the 1 minute, 0.5 minute, 1 minute, 1.5, like that. You will get decrease in the temperature because solution becomes cool. That's why you are getting the decrease in temperature. Same way you can do it for the set 2. There is a mixture of biphenylamine and the naphthalene. And you can see the highest temperature reached to this particular thing is that 82. You can see here melting point has been decreases by the addition of the another substance. Okay, that is the depression of the freezing point. This reading you have to note up to the 15 minute. After the 15 minute, we have to plot the graph. We have to plot the graph of this particular temperature versus the time. Temperature versus the time. There will be the 2 gram. First graph will be only for the naphthalene powder, and second graph will be for the naphthalene plus biphenyl plus naphthalene. This lowest graph you can see here. This graph is for the pure naphthalene, and the another this graph is for the naphthalene plus biphenyl mixture. Okay, we have to plot this graph, and after plotting this graph, we can calculate. You will get the 2 temperatures, T0 and T. T0 for the pure compound, T is for the mixture. And from this T and T0, we will calculate the delta TF. Once we get the delta TF, then we will calculate the molecular weight of the biphenyl easily by using the formula delta TF is equal to KF into W2 into 1000 divided by M2 into W1. All these things are with us. Weight of the biphenyl we have, weight of the naphthalene we have. KF is given to you 7 degree per mole per kilogram. 7 degree per mole per kilogram. Then we will calculate the molecular weight of this biphenylamine. Biphenyl, the molecular weight. The molecular weight of the biphenyl will be calculated by using the formula KF into W2 into 1000 divided by W1 into delta TF. Substitute all the values in this formula and we will get this particular molecular weight of the biphenyl, that is a 140 gram per mole. In the result, just we have to note the molecular weight of the biphenyl. Very simple experiment it is again. Not we have to do anything. We have to take that particular naphthalene, pure naphthalene in one test tube, and the mixture of the biphenyl plus naphthalene in the another test tube. We have to melt that particular naphthalene above the melt 5 degree centigrade, above the 5 degree centigrade of its own melting point. Naphthalene is having melting point 80 degree centigrade. We are going to heat this compound up to the 85 degree centigrade. Then we are removing that tube from the that particular paraffin oil bath, and we are keeping it in the dry beaker, and we are recording the temperature. We have inserted the thermometer in this particular tube. Okay, please go through this experiment. It is very simple experiment again. This is a Rast method that is in your theory also. Okay. This same procedure we have written there for the Rast method. Okay, we are taking the finely powder compound in the test tube. Okay, then we are going to do this particular thing in the test tube. We are filling that and we are keeping it in the 250 cmq of the beaker containing the paraffin oil bath. Boiling tube is mentioned, but we not necessary to do the take the boiling tube. This we can do simply in our laboratory. Very simple experiment it is again. Please go through this experiment. Okay. If you have any doubt, any difficulty, you can ask. Here we are going to this experiment is basically the colligative property. In the viva, the question will be based on the what are the colligative properties, what is the depression in the freezing point, is the what is the molar depression constant, what is the molar kyroscopic constant. Okay, that's what that the same this question may be there in the viva. Please go through this experiment well. If you have any problem, any difficulty while writing this experiment, you can ask. You have to note these readings with the help of the pencil only. Okay, when you come in the laboratory and we will perform actual experiment, we will fare that experiment in the your written journal. Okay, here this 6th experiment of this particular physical chemistry has been finished. Please go through this, please read this theory well, because the viva will be based on this theory part only, and other question in the syllabus it is in the detail. how we have determined this particular depression in the freezing point, you know very well. And based on this thing, the question will be there in the exam. Okay, this is about the whole about the experiment number 6. Please complete the experiment daily. These two experiments you have to complete.